I'm sure you've read the Washington Post reporting by this point, that came out about an hour ago, full transcript of the president's conversation with two world leaders, including the president of Mexico, where he concedes that the wall is not the most important issue, but the most important politically, and also essentially concedes that, you know, he knows that Mexico's not going to pay for it. They'll figure that out. That'll, quote, come out in the wash, but he cannot have the president of Mexico saying that publicly. What do you make of that?
Well, I think it's another bit of campaign rhetoric. It's highly unusual, but I don't think anyone during the campaign seriously thought that Mexico would pay for that wall, even though we all desperately believe in the wall as a metaphor for border security.
Do you feel like it was a campaign promise? Because that's what it sounded like when the president would say at every rally he gave, I'm going to build a wall, and who's going to pay for it? The crowd would shout, Mexico. You don't think that was a campaign promise?
Well, you know, these campaigns are full of all kinds of comments, promises, commitments, expressions, vitriolic diatribe, and you know, once the campaign's over, it's time to move on to government.
Time to not implement what you promised you would implement? I'm just confused how you chalk this up. But yeah, something he said, but no one believed it.
Well, there's been a lot of those. There's a lot of things people have said during campaigns that turned out not to be believed later. It might have been better had he not got the Mexico part out.
Hold on, Congressman. He said it after the campaign. I mean, he said it in the White House. He may even say it again tonight at his rally in West Virginia. And then he made clear to the president of Mexico in this phone call, while he was sitting, you know, president in the White House, that, no, I don't actually really think you're going to pay for it, but just please don't say that publicly because, quote, the press is going to go with that, and I cannot live with that. Are you comfortable with that from this president?
I think it would have been better had he not distracted the discussion of border security by bringing up who's going to pay for the wall and what kind of wall it would be. We have a lot of ways that we can strengthen our border, and physical barriers are one, technology is another, and I think we need to be getting about doing that.
I guess what we're really trying to get from you as someone who is a Republican member of Congress, who's been very supportive of the president, do you think he was, knowing what you know from this transcript, which the White House is not disputing openly, do you think he was straight and honest with the American people?
Well, I don't think anyone really thought that the Mexicans were going to pay for a wall. I mean, regardless of a boisterous campaign or post-campaign comment, you know, these politicians, these professional politicians make comments all the time. President Trump was not a professional politician, so maybe he made even some more comments that might be disputed later. But the bottom line is, no one could really believe that Mexicans were going to pay for a wall, and no one would believe that we don't need to secure our borders. So those are two asymmetrical concepts there.
Can I ask, how should this color how we view other promises then that come from, given that he made this promise and may not have meant it as you're suggesting, how should we perceive other promises that come from the president?
Well, how about the promises for the last 8 years to repeal and replace Obamacare? I mean, there's a whole lot of promises that politicians have broken, and no wonder the American people want to see some things done, some concrete things done to fix our country, fix our workforce, and get the economy growing again.
All right, Congressman Francis Rooney of Florida, busy, busy day. Thank you so much for being with us. Appreciate it.
Thanks for having me on.